Hey folks, I'm Commander Red Falcon, and I would like to welcome you to the Abyss. Yes, the Abyss. It's a region of space. Let me show you. That's the Abyss. Well, that's where the Abyss is in relation to everything else. And right in front of us, well, that's the Milky Way. And we're going this way. Yep. Actually, specifically this way. It's dark out here, so it is appropriately named. So, this next stop should be the fleet carrier Tartarus, where we can sell our data and hopefully rank up, fix up the ship, and then our next stop will be Beagle Point. So, make sure everything looks good on the chat and the stream, and we'll get started. Alright, had to deal with a little cat aggro, but I'm back. Alright, let's get this thing started. Hopefully we don't jump right into a black hole. Because there's supposed to be a black hole here. And you know how I hate black holes. That is black. Alright. Ugh, hate black holes. Oh, there it is. DSSA Tartarus. A nice view of the galaxy right there. Okay, we should be correct distance. I think that's the Skull Nebula. Alright. Wow, it is dark. There we go. Had to turn the night vision on. It's so dark out here in the Abyss. Fleet carrier. All right. Will do. Of course, I don't know what standard docking procedure on a carrier means. I guess don't hit it. Damn, not a ruptured power manifold. I don't know if you can hear the radio chatter. There. Got it. All right, let's go underground. Well, welcome to a carrier, Commander. Oh, turn these lights off. Don't need those. Don't need my night vision either. All right, we're all tucked in. Nice and safe. Let's see what kind of services we have available to us. Okay, good. We can sell our stuff. That's good. All right, let's go. Chip integrity. Wow, we're at 48%. Paint works at 48%. Cargo hatch. Hull. Integrity, fix that. Hull, fix that. Do I want to repaint it? I'll wait on that. Don't have any limpets. Okay, my vehicles. Ah, let's go ahead and restock these. Everything looks good here. Okay. Advanced maintenance, workshop. Okay, well, you guys probably don't care about that. Let's see how much money we made. All right, let's see. We are at 227.4 million credits. So, you know what? 100 million. We're gonna go with that. Okay, what's this? Okay, so this page alone is 26 million. I've never sold using the carrier interface. This is new. Well, new for me. I forgot what my balance was. 227. Incoming message. Congratulations, Commander. You've earned the following acolytes. First to discover. Yeah. Quite a few. Wait, was that it? No, there had to be more than that. There we go. 9 million right there. Congratulations, you've earned the following acolytes. First to discover end map, look at that. Oh, I see. Carrier fees 25%, which is fine. I mean, I appreciate them having this out here, so I'm good with that. Okay, 10.7 right there. Congratulations, you've earned the following acolytes. First discover, bam, 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 bam. try this again. Well, I am more than happy to use this carrier service. Okay, so that's 10 right there. I must have ranked up already. This is ridiculous. I should have ranked up by now. Actually, I bet once I close out of this, I'll rank up. $35 million right here. Congratulations! First to discover! Yep. It almost seems faster if I leave and then come back. No, I guess not. 9.9 million there. Congratulations. First to discover. Alright. I don't know why I just can't sell it all at once. Probably like a packet limit or something. Ooh, 20 right there. Oh, that's the biggest single page. No, that was 35 earlier. So not the biggest. All right. First to discover in the app. Ooh, look at that. $6 million. First to discover. Alright. Oh, damn. Yep. $359 million. So I got way more. Oh, look. And there's my rank. I'm elite now. Yes. I'm excited about that. Alright, let's see what else we got. Nope, that's all my data. And where's my pilot's promotion? There it is. Woohoo! I got my wings. Look at that. Elite. All right. Outfitting. Oh, facility. Oh, that's fine. I don't need the fuel. Though I did restock all those other modules. You know what? I'm going to put a new... a new thing. I gotta put my elite wings on my ship. Alright. Oops. Alright, hold on. There we go. I can't touch type to save my life. I've just changed my ship's registration number to RED04. Looks like Rito 4. Oh well. Romeo Echo Delta 04. Ask Explorer Arctic Tern. Get our new decals on there. We're not a pioneer anymore. No. Elite. Look at that. We'll leave all that the way it is. Cockpit accessories the same. Oh, I gotta update my scarabs too. Point I need to buy like a second. Actually, how much is a second color for one of these guys? Oh, I could actually afford that. Yellow. What's my current color? Vibrant yellow. Subdued yellow. I feel like I need to do something to celebrate this occasion. You know what? Sure. There. So now I've got one SRV that's yellow and one that's red. Cool. All right, let's see. Aerial review, crew lounge. All right, I think we're ready to go. There's not much else we can do here. Let me put in our next coordinate. I'll be right back. It's actually a huge relief. Because I'm always nervous about my ship getting destroyed and losing all that data. But now that data's been taken care of, I got my money and my credit. Ah, that looks so good, seeing that 100% elite rank right there. 359 million credits. I mean, it's not a billion, but it's a lot. Okay. Let's see. Available or careful. I think it's time to take some pictures. don't like that green color. I don't know what it is about it. Ooh, here we go. This is actually a pretty good shot, if I can get the angle right. See how these pictures turned out. All right, looks like I can use those. All right. Well, thank you for your services, Tartarus. Well, we got. Here. So let's
frameshift drive charging.
Let's jump into Super Cruise here and take a look.
Three, two, one, engage.
Oh wow, look at that like green tinge to it. That's really cool. Alright. Let's go below the orbital plane. Let's find some stuff. Gas giants, icy bodies. Compared to the galactic core, this is barren. are you? Appropriate song. It's about Mass Effect, Andromeda. Figures there wouldn't be anything around the black hole. Let's see, I was checking my discoveries. I think I'm at like 450 or 470 first finds. What information do we have about this? Disabled facilities, refuel, shipyard, black market, redemption office, yeah. Commander Nusparo. Oh, it's got it found the system. Cool. Deep Space Support Array. DSSA. Deep Space Support Array. Yep, there's... Seems like a pretty cool squadron. Alright. Well, we are 28 jumps from the nearest neutron star, according to my route planner. So. Alright. Feeling good. Paid. Oh, I forgot something. I gotta put my new rank on. Let's see here. Accessories. Cosmetics. Where the hell is it? Ah, there we go. Explorer Pioneer? No, sir. How about Explorer Elite? There we go. Look at that. Got those nice... Huh. Oh. Interesting. Yeah, it looks nice. That looks nice. I'm gonna save. Damn it. Yeah, looking nice. Looking nice. All right. Now that's done.
Frameship drive charging.
I feel... Yeah, you can see it. It's a lower res texture, but it's over there on the... on my ship. Thank you. fuel scoop for a second. Yeah, good call, like, not having refueling services, especially this far out. If you don't have a fuel scoop, I don't know how you got out here. Maybe you hitched a ride on a fleet carrier? Going to assume this has been discovered by someone already. Yeah. Yep. Well, one rank down, two more to go. I'm not even halfway through this expedition. We haven't even arrived at the destination yet. Oh, I gotta remember, I gotta update the graphics on all my stream and everything later. To reflect my new status.
Fuel scooping. System scan complete.
Now, if I didn't already have it, getting elite rank would get me access to the Founder's World. But since I pre-ordered the game years ago, I already had that access. Some asteroid clusters. Oops. I moved everything slightly, so now my buttons are a little off. I gotta remember where they are. So one of the issues playing with a headset is you're pretty much blind to all like the real inputs. Money I've ever had in this game.
Fuel scooping. Fuel scooping complete.
Holy crap. Just look how dark it is. I'm serious. Just look how dark it is in front of me. There are no stars. This place creeps me out a little bit. I mean, that's why they call it the Abyss, right? Looks like there are some planets that haven't been discovered yet. Let me go ahead and grab those. Cluster of stuff over here.
System scan complete.
I'll go ahead and grab these asteroid clusters. I mean, they're not, you don't get credit for them, I know, but I'm a bit of a completionist. Done. Alright, where are we at? There we are. Next one.
Frameshift drive charging.
Man. We're out there. I think we passed the 60,000 light year mark. Or we're really close to it. Like, technically, when I started the stream, I was at like 59,700 and something light years. I couple jumps, we should be there. That's distance from Seoul now, by the way.
System scan complete. Fuel scooping. Fuel scooping complete.
Also, if you want to see just how far everything is, that's... those are the nearby stars. There's like one. Well, I forgot what the limit is for the navigation pane. It doesn't show you like every single nearby star. I think if it's beyond a certain range, it just doesn't show it. But it's okay. I built this ship to handle the distances here, so we should be fine. Bodies to discover here. I guess people are just in a hurry and they just kind of rush past these. So, there are several fleet carriers like the Tartarus permanently stationed at various parts in deep space. We're probably going to visit one or two of them on our way back from Beagle Point. Just as a point where we can refuel and... not refuel. Repair, rearm, rest... Tartarus, well, obviously, fleet carriers were introduced earlier this year, so that was a point of interest, and last time I checked, there were only maybe about less than 200 people. Actually, there's probably more now, so I'm going to be pretty high up on that visitor list. I'll probably be on the first page. Two bodies, huh?
Fuel scooping complete.
Okay, let's go. Ooh. Fat urn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, it looks like you've actually found all of them. I'm not gonna worry about that. Those have already been scanned. At this point, it's oddly freeing because now I'm not worried about scanning things for the sake of making money anymore. I mean, the extra money's nice, but I've already made my rank, so it's very liberating. Like, if I jump into a system that just doesn't look interesting and say, nope, I'm done. And I don't feel compelled to go out of my way to scan a system that someone's already scanned.
Fuel scooping.
It's like when you hit the max level on an MMO.
Fuel scooping complete.
Ooh, what did I discover? Metal-rich plant with atmosphere, non-terraformable. Okay. I mean, there's still the codex entries, I guess. We got a ways to go, though. And that's just to, what do you call it? Neutron star. And there's only like 4 or 5 neutron stars between us and Beagle Point. Well, that are on my route. Quite a few of these. Yeah. 11 bodies. Yeah, that might have been 11.
Frameshift drive.
That's another thing. Because the stars are so spaced out, there are limited routes through this region of space, so you're going to find a lot of stuff that's already been discovered. Honestly, the whole point of this is to say we've been the furthest from the solar system anyone's been.
Fuel seeking.
We got 13 bodies. Bobo TW. Yeah, we're treading where many have treaded before. I mean, that's one of the issues with taking a route like this. But it's kind of those rites of passages for explorers, much like going the Hutton Orbital. This is one of those things that you should do at least once.
Fuel scooping.
Team here. I'm gonna go out on a limb and assume that we've been. Clear?
Alright.
Make sure we were clear from that. Well, what's nice about this is we can kind of just enjoy the ride as we go. So I'm not having to worry about putting in new waypoints in the computer for a while. And I can just kind of, fuel's not really an issue. Oh yeah, that looks like 18 to me. Let's clear this planet, or this planet, the star. It's like the king of the planets. Let's see here. Let's get lined up. System map. What else we got? Ooh. Hello. The system hasn't been scanned. It's one of those honkin' scoop deals. Giant, yep. Lots of gas giants with satellites. Working our way through this. Stupid joystick starting, side buttons are starting to not register. Oh, so apparently there was some more information released about the Space Legs expansion. Officially known as Elite Dangerous Odyssey. So apparently the ability to walk around the interiors of your ship will not be a launch day feature, which, you know, some people are upset about it, but honestly, it's, you know, there's a lot of... Oh, why am I here? That's not where I want to be. Honestly, there's a lot to it. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. One second. I think there might be some planets here that no one's found. Let's take a look. maybe not, maybe I was wrong. Yeah. One toe. Yeah, he already found all these, it looks like. Okay, never mind. But, yeah, I mean, you gotta understand, I think that they want to be able to do the ship interiors right. At least, I'm giving the developers the benefit of a doubt. They want to do ship interiors right, so, you know, a small ship like a Sidewinder, yeah, that would be pretty straightforward to design the interior, but if we're talking a larger ship, like an Anaconda, that's just, no. That's going to take a while to fully flesh out the interior, design everything, texture everything, and test it. And personally, I don't want them to do a half-assed job. Which, X4 Foundation. Don't get me wrong, I love the X series games. I've spent way more time than should be allowed to play those games, but... one of the features I was excited about with X4 was the ability to, you know, actually, you know, walk around inside your ship. And unfortunately, yeah, on the larger ships, there's really only like three areas you can go. The cockpit, any type of hangar that the ship might have, and the airlock to enter and exit the ship. So, like I said, I want Elite Dangerous to not half-ass it like that. In my opinion. So, I'm kind of glad that they're gonna take their time on that and release it as a future update. So, that's my thoughts on it anyway, for what that's worth. But who knows? They might make us wait 6 to 8 months for this patch, and they end up half-assing it, so I don't know. Because the cockpit, I mean, the cockpit's done already, pretty much. All the ships have very detailed cockpits, but I just want to know what's behind that door. So, who knows? And it's not going to be VR compatible, which is fine. I get it. Locomotion. Ha! 69. It's hard to do VR locomotion right. And I found that this is the kind of VR that I like. The stationary... oh, crap. Oh, wow. No one's... Okay. There are 69 bodies I need to scan here. So, let's go ahead and dive down a little bit here. Oh, boy. Gas Giant. Water World, I bet that's... Yeah, I bet someone's already scanned that Water World. Might be here a while, folks. I got a lot of bodies to scan. But it looks like if anyone did scan all these planets, they haven't turned in the data yet and gotten credit, so... So many levels. Well, magnification levels, I mean. Well, if everything goes as planned, next week we should be at Beagle Point. I think I have another, like, 5,000 light years to go. Now, granted, it's going to be a little slower because we don't have as many neutron stars in between, but I think I can make that journey off stream. Get us there. But we will see. Also, that reminds me, I need to actually make a forum account on the official forums and put my name in the 65,000 club. That's for people who have traveled 65,000 light years from Earth. I don't know, it's probably like a very packed club at this point. Beagle Point alone, the point of interest visitor log has something like 5,000 people, unique commanders. So, you know, it's kind of become like Mount Everest is now. It's almost like a cliche. So many people visit Mount Everest that there are lines forming at the summit, if you can believe that. Here we go. What was that? Oh, then I gotta figure out like if any of these planets are worth mapping. Ugh. I almost don't want to. I mean, at this point, I'm kind of doing it just for bragging rights. In a remote part of the system, no one's probably going to see. Yep. Asp. Shepen. Shepen? Yeah, someone already found that one. Not too worried. Wait, did he map it too? Huh. He didn't map it. Interesting. This would be the first to map it. Oh, it depends on how far away it is, to be honest. What are we looking at here? There we go. Oh, there we go. Let's get call. And the rest of these are probably going to be satellites. Okay, I didn't miss anything. Okay, good. All right, and there's probably some lonely planets around here somewhere. I don't want to call them lonely. They're independent planets. They don't need a gas giant to support them. They have their own orbital path, thank you very much. Strong, independent planets. Ah, here we go. Damn! Where the hell do I start? I guess I'll start. I don't even know if I want to map any of these, to be honest. I mean, this one has some geological features. Could be interesting. I'd like to scan those. We'll see if we can find... Oh, that one. Yeah, these all have geological features. Those are ice bodies. Not candidates. This one looks promising. Ah. First discovered, but he has not mapped it. Ooh, that one's a candidate. Oh boy, we gotta climb this. Make this thing go any faster. There we go, that's better. Use the mouse to kinda. There we go, come on. There we go. Hey, there we go. That works. Discovered a bunch of these planets, but he did not map any of them. Ugh, I don't know if I'm gonna bother. Oh, 313,000 light seconds. Ugh. That's a long way. I don't know if I want to do that. How badly do I want my name on this planet as a first mapped by? Of course, it had to be the furthest planet. What the hell? You only YOLO once, right? Damn, that's gonna take a while, though. I don't know if I wanna... Maybe 10 minutes? 15 minutes? It's gonna take my ship a while to even get up to that speed. You know, I haven't checked the chat in a while, see what you guys are talking about. Okay, doesn't look like talking about anything. Good. I don't have to respond. Ah, damn, is this space madness taking a hold? Yeah, I think the space madness is starting to set in. Well, there's just, I don't know, like, there is something about being on the outer edge of the Milky Way that just kinda messes with your head a little bit. Like, there is home in that cluster of stars, and then out here is just nothing. It truly is an abyss. Just darkness. Really, really puts things in perspective. All the problems you think matter, don't really matter. That's the way I see it anyway. Being out here. Well, virtually out here anyway. Okay, well, we shouldn't have any other bodies crop up, so that shouldn't affect our speed any, so. We should get there reasonable speed. Yeah, what the hell. Hopefully there's a fleet carrier Beagle Point I can sell this data, so I can get my name on those planets. I like whoever did the scan, just didn't bother to scan anything except the high-value planets. And I just come in here, scan everything, and actually fly over. That's got to be some... I don't know if that's, like, dedication, maybe a little pettiness, who knows. Nah, I'm not petty. Well, I mean... 26 minutes is better than a year, 4 years, right? See, how many planets are orbiting this star? I might just map them all. I mean, why not, right? Oh, here comes the sad cowboy song. Oh, look, it's a cube. 1, 2, 3, 4. Actually, I wonder if any of these have any anomalies. A couple of these planets I can land on. Let's see here. Ooh, that one's got some geological anomalies. And what about this one? None. That one does, though. Kind of looks like a tiger. Looks like it's got tiger stripes. Let's see. What's the gravity? Ooh, yeah. 0.13G. Like it. Yeah, screw it. I'm just going to scan all these planets. Well, I don't know if I want to scan these ice bodies. You know what? Why not? I'm flying all this way. I might as well. Ah, there we go. 11 minutes. I like that. And we're still gaining speed, so we haven't even... reached that star's gravitational influence. DE1, huh? Much to do here except sit in this cockpit, wait for those numbers to go down, and contemplate my existence. Oh, here's the stats page. Max distance from start. 60,000. So I've already done that. Highest payout, 9.4 million. Profits from exploration, 434 million. Hmm. Ooh, abandoned settlement? Mining team 6? Generation ships? Hey! These are all my logs! Oh, this is cool. Yeah, these are all my my archived beacons. That's cool. I didn't know that was here. Abandoned settlements, mining team 6. Haven't found any generation ships yet. Great Annihilator, Explorer's Anchorage, Goliath's Rest. History of Lave, or the mug. Here we go. This is proof that I made it to Hutton Orbital. Many commanders see it as a rite of passage to visit Hutton Orbital. Make sure to buy a souvenir mug while you're there. And I did, and I sold it. Bought a whole cargo load full of it. Yep, these are all the Jameson. Ship analysis. Ship analysis complete. High concentrations of microwave particle detected searching for some database. Designation Cobra Mark III, registered pilot. Oh, cool. My session log, all the stuff I've done today. Ah, that's better. Okay. Looks like we're entering the influence of that star. Or we've already entered the influence of that star, so we're slowing down. 2 minutes. I can live with that. Oh, good. My SRVs were refueled. Perfect. I mean, I feel like if I'm going to make this journey, I might as well make it worth my time, so I'm going to look at the, check out that satellite's, there's a natural satellite there that's got, look like some geological points that I want to check out. Oh, yeah, I mean, we're heading to the water world, but... Oh, okay, here it is. Ooh, I might take my red SRV out. Now that I've got my new decals. There we go. Now we're... Okay, so yeah, these planets are still in range. This is going to be annoying if these planets are still closer. I mean, not super annoying, but... annoying, regular annoying. Looks like this guy's actually closer, so we'll adjust accordingly. Oop, not ready for you yet. What's this? BE2. It's a gas jet. Oh, okay, I see now. Okay, I see. So we're dealing with two separate stars. Okay, that makes sense. That's why these gas giants are showing up with the DE abbreviation, because they're right between, gravitationally speaking, star D and star E. Okay. That makes a lot more sense. Okay. Okay. Just had to figure it out. Okay, we're gonna scan, we're gonna map you, map your satellite. Go wheels down on that satellite. Take a look. All right. Okay, so I underestimated how much money I was gonna get by like 25-ish million. Oh crap, I'm gonna overshoot it. Damn it. Yeah. Put a dollar in the swear jar. Okay, here we are. Yeah, I don't care. I'm just going to scan all these planets nearby. As I flew out here, I might as well. Oh, damn it. There we go. Oh, that's a par 4. It's not going to need all those. I think we're pretty safe. Actually, I need those results so I can plot a landing.
Surface scanned by 50%.
All right. 12 geological anomalies. I call them anomalies. I don't know why. Points of interest. There we go. Signals. Guess we can call them that. All right. Hopefully that's not... Kinda like the position of this one better.
I'm
works. Let's turn this off. A lot of pop marks on this one. All right, there we go. Right there. I think we're on a good approach. So I wonder what's on this planet. I would guess probably geysers. More geysers. That's really cool about the archive, though. I didn't know about that. Glad I visited all those tourist beacons. I don't know what it is. I have a hard time saying that T word. It either sounds like Taurus, like the bull, or terrorist. Taurist. There we go. Taurist. Taurist. Little speech therapy here. Taurist. Taurist beacon. Taurist. That's what happens when you, spend half your childhood up north and then come down south. Can't talk right. Alright. Should be... Alright, we have finished our glide. Let's bring ourselves around here. Oh, that's perfect. Well, kind of. I don't like this angle, but... I'm not flying a plane. Gravity's still pretty low. Oh yeah, I should probably activate the ship's night vision. There we go. Hey, oh, much better. I can actually see. Well, there's something shiny down there. Could be crystalline structures. Or more like geysers. We're about to find out. Spot to land or set her down. I'm just trying to show you just how well I know you. I understand just how you feel. Through your reason, you had one bad day and your mind let go of the still we're fated to battle. You pout and I prattle. Don't you ever tire of this game. But you know. Hard finding a landing spot around here. Where you think Oh, there we go. There, oh, almost. There we go. Just lower her down gently. Just his cape and his cave and his. There we go. All right. Well, we really don't need a. We are two of the kind, Lyland, don't sound of mine, you're the yin to my yang, can't you see? And if I were to leave you with grumble and grief, face it, that's you. I think you're the red one. We're about to find out. Yep, this is the red one. Cool. Yeah, I got that. Alright. See what's out here. It's kind of freaky seeing those lights. I mean, those are planets. Crystalline fragments. Yeah, I'm gonna go out on a. Whoa, look at that. Huh. Now that is something. Wow. Hold on a minute. I gotta like. See, what are the preset? Garbage. 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 Yeah. The camera's better anyway. Okay, that should be enough. I'm gonna say I'm a bit of a shutterbug. I don't know, I'm liking this paint scheme. Can I scan any of these rocks? Let's see here. Where's that button? There we go. Oh, cool. Biological and something, something. What did I find? Sulfur dioxide. Fumarole. Okay, cool. Assume those are the same. Yep. Okay. Cool. Let's see here. I hate that I have to switch between, like, analysis mode and combat mode. Well, that was dumb. I actually got stuck between two of those things. Yeah. Stuck, relatively speaking. Mercury. That's bad if you eat it. Okay, I'm gonna scan one of the smoky ones and see if there's anything interesting coming out of that. I doubt I'm gonna get anything new. You never know. Isn't going to be a repeat of Luna's Shadow, is it? Carbon. Bah. Plain old carbon. Bet this thing's gonna be more carbon. Nickel. Damn it. Come on. Oh, phosphorus. Okay. Common, but used a lot in engineering. Well, at least the kind of engineering I like. I'm not going to worry too much about these. It's the smoky bit that I'm interested in. Yeah. Nope. Nothing interesting. Okay. No. Let's head back to the ship. I'm gonna finish mapping the rest of these planets. Yeah, I'm kind of glad I bought this second paint job. Because prior, both of my SRVs were yellow. I'm like, you know what? Make the second one a different color. Just to mix things up a little. And I believe that was all premium currency I earned playing the game, so. Yeah. I mean, 70, whatever, right? My ship's on the other side of this hill. Oh, yeah, that one little rock there is enough to cause you to spin out. Oh, easy now. Great, how many hills is this thing behind? Yeah, I don't trust the ship's AI to find another suitable landing spot. I had a hard enough time finding a suitable landing spot. Back up. Alright. Let's see what we got here. Turn that off. Alright, I think we're good. Retracted. Where are we going now? Okay, so we mapped you. Have we mapped you yet? Nope. Now we're going to the first planet. Engage our super cruise, get out of here. That was a fun little excursion. Come on. There we go. I don't know why it took a second for it to figure out I was trying to line up with that escape velocity. Escape vector. Escape velocity. Something different. Delta V, if I remember correctly. Goodbye, planet. Fun little excursion. Much money. Oh, you know what? I forgot to cash in my Codex Discovery vouchers. Oh, well. It's not much. It's like 50,000 credits. Like, okay. Great. I mean, I'm sure if you're a new pilot, that's a lot of money. I don't know. It's almost like, why? And it's not like anyone... Well, I think someone may have already made that discovery. Like, discovered, like, that thing in this region, and then I just confirmed it by finding it on another planet. I think that's how it works. Oh, there's so many, like, half-ass mechanics in this game. We will see. Good to see that hull back up at 100%. Oh, crap. Yeah, one paying attention. Yeah, yeah. It's another dollar in the swear jar. Oh, crap. There we go. At least I've mastered the loop of shame. I can loop around and come out exactly where I want to be. So, you know, there's that, I guess. First discovered by this guy, but gonna be first mapped by me. Because you didn't take the time to come out here. Yeah, that should be enough to... You. I have not mapped you yet.
Surface scan complete.
Let's see if I can avoid the loop of shame this time. Though that was a pretty cool picture with, like, the star and, like, all the planets. Yeah. That was pretty neat. Alright. We're dropping speed pretty quick here. Who's next? We did one.
Surface scan complete.
All right, cool. What's next? Four. So we already did. Yeah, we already did. Five and six, because why not? Okay, slow you down a bit. Ah, another dollar in the swear jar. I'm not doing good today. It's just a bad day for approaching planets. Too fast. good enough.
Oh yeah, that's a that's a four. That's a four.
Okay. Five, I believe, is the next one.
Surface scanned by 50%. Surface scan complete.
Oh man. Okay, let's see. It's different out here, that's for sure. Next. Four, two, one, six.
Surface scanned by 50%. Surface scan complete.
Right on. All right, six. And the last one? Only six planets? I sworn there were more. Okay, works for me. Yeah, it doesn't look like four had any points of interest. Sometimes they don't. Distances, like the scale and distance, they just keep going up. Because you got the distance between stars, okay, fine. But then you have the distance between galaxies. And that makes my brain hurt. This one looks like a big one. Oh, no, six. Or par six. Sometimes these sixes don't take four like that, so I might have to get another one. We'll see where the probes land.
Scanned by 50%.
Okay, never mind.
Scan complete.
All right, let's get ourselves lined up here. Take one last look at our system here and make sure we didn't forget anybody. Okay, you have mapped. 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 And you have mapped. Cool. Fun. Yeah, gotta have a little fun with it, right? Wow, we might not make it to the neutron star on the stream. So we'll see. See how far we can make it. Engage. bodies. A thirsty ship, apparently. Alright. Let's see. Oh. That's interesting. Asp Shepard, huh? Well, he didn't bother scanning the rest of this planet, this system either. I mean, he's probably in a hurry. Well, they were probably in a hurry. Thing worth looking at? Huh. Let's see what we got here. Nope. 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 Man, all these look pretty. Does it have any features? Nope. Oh, nothing even with features. Okay. Interesting. Alright. Off to the next, I guess. I think I got a graphical glitch here, because where it's supposed to say system map, it's got like surface map, kind of like on top of it. So it'll probably go away once I log out of the game, but interesting little glitch.
System scan complete. Fuel scooping.
Well, this system's no more than just a gas stop.
Complete.
Or a bridge. I think bridge is better. No, it's kind of like a gas station bridge. If that makes sense. You can refuel, and it helps get you somewhere.
Frameshift drive charging.
Helps bridge the gap. Bodies, I should say.
Fuel scooping complete.
Let's see what we got here. Oh, yep. Hasn't mapped them. That's fine by me. More credit for me. Oh, here we go. There's a lot of stuff going on here. What do we got here? Let's see if there's anything worth a second look or a more detailed look. Oh, hello. Terraforming candidate. Okay. Another one. Unmapped. Nope. Okay, so we got two terraformable candidates. Why not, right? Can't land on any of these planets, except for that one, but didn't have anything interesting on it. Alright. These are pretty close together, I think, so this shouldn't take too long. Yeah, one and two are pretty close. Alright. Hey, it's money. I'm still not at a billion credits yet. Why not? Yeah. Thought I was gonna do the loop of shame this time. Didn't. Damn the space madness. It didn't really start to hit me until after I got into the Abyss. Like, the Abyss just messes with your mind, I'm telling you. Okay. I challenge any of you deep space explorers out there, or aspiring deep space explorers, come out to the Abyss. Okay, maybe the VR headset helps. Come out here and you tell me you don't go a little crazy. Go a little nutty. Set a par 6. That should be enough. Boom. Got it. Getting better at that. The old, probe and dash. Sounds dirty. Probe and dash. Damn. It's just hard to believe we've been above the galactic plane, below the galactic plane, inside the galactic plane, and now we're so far away that the galactic plane is I can see the whole thing. Space is big, messes with your head. Thankfully, space madness doesn't make you a worse pilot.
Boom.
All right, I think that's all the planets.
Frameshift drive charging.
Not bad.
Of course, this is kind of the equivalent of putting your name on a tree next to a highway. Like, no one's gonna see it. Unless they know what they're looking for. But, yeah. It's fine.
Take a look.
Ooh, yeah. Wait a minute. I think it was just these two, to be honest. Yeah, nothing interesting. Okay. Let's go until we hit that first neutron star, and we can end the stream. And that's a good point to end the night. And over this next week, I will work very hard to make sure we are able to get to Beagle Point within the time frame for next week's stream. Oh. And then after that, we start our journey back. Though we're not going the way we came, we're actually going to be going around the galaxy, so to speak. Taking the long way around. More or less following the distant worlds to flight path. More or less, making a few adjustments here and there. Nobody scanned these. Okay. Maybe someone did and they haven't uploaded the data yet. That's probably what happened. I'm just shocked that there's so many of these systems that aren't fully mapped, or fully scanned. What's this? All right. Luckily, these planets are all kind of near each other. It's got geological features. That's interesting. Would I go for the one that's got more geological features or fewer geological features? One's got 8. They're just geological features. I'm not too worried about those. You know what? Maybe it's the space madness, but I'm gonna take a better look at these. Yeah, we might not make it to that neutron star. That's fine. So we can check the stream in a while. Nothing on the chat. Alright. We are approaching the planet. It's got... Oh! No, they're right next to each other. Perfect. Alright. Just a lot of range. Throttle right there. Slow down as we approach. Okay, might be going a little too slow. Okay. It's probably like a par 4. Oh, par 2. Okay. I'm kind of curious. How much does one one probe do for me? Oh, so I do have to use 2. Okay, interesting. Well, since they're right next to each other, twins. I'm just gonna call them twins. Twin planets.
Surface scan complete.
Geological signals on this one. I have a feeling the other one's gonna have like similar.
Scan complete.
Like 5. Okay. Well, let's go with the one that's got more. My gut does tell me to go to the one with fewer. Oh wow. Well. I always like to try to land on the sunny side, if I can. Alright, you guys are getting, our viewers are getting 2 planetary landings in this stream. Aren't you lucky?
Oh crap.
It's a little too steep of an approach. That's part of the problem, right? Getting a good approach. circle this location for a little bit. Yeah. Stupid menu. It's a small planet. I wasn't expecting the gravity to be super high, so we're good in that regard. But we are close to that star. We might need to use our night vision in the crater there. One day I'll figure out a good approach. I don't know. I think part of it is sometimes these geological signals just are not in the right spot. Ooh, what's that? Looks like more gas. Night vision here, so we can get a better look. Here we go. Turn on our engine here.
Lighting gear deployed.
This. Is that suitable? Very picky. Okay. It did not like that. I took red out. Let's take yellow out. Ooh, there's a lot of stuff out here. Switch you over.
Oh, did I not set my weapon, my fire groups on this? I guess I didn't. Okay, there we go. There we go.
these little anomalies are. What did I make? Sulfur dioxide gas vent. Well, that's exciting. It's just a gas vent, guys. Nothing to be excited about. All right, well, I think I'm going to end the stream here. I want to thank all of you for watching. These streams are every Wednesday at 5 p.m. Eastern. Go ahead and follow me on Twitch to get updates. You can also get updates on this stream by following my Twitter account at RedFalcon2K6. All these streams are archived on my YouTube channel. Just do a search for Red Falcon Expedition to Beagle Point. You should be able to find them up there. These usually go up midnight the next day. So if you subscribe there and you're not able to make the stream, no big deal. You can just follow there. Let's see, what else? I think that's about it. Thank you again, and be safe out there.